All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Osu Mania Squid Game. Today, we've got the first game results and also the showcase for the second game. My name is Dynascape, and today I'm joined by none other than one of the hosts of Squid Game, Rhymes with Mash.
Hello, everybody. Great to see you all showing up to check out these results and the second game showcase coming up soon. So we are going to be starting with the results. So how about we just get into it?
Yeah, of course. Let's go ahead and see who made it through to the second game.
And so those who did not show up to their lobbies or schedule a lobby, of course, are eliminated. So there is a significant chunk that are not even eligible. But here are those who did not qualify, unfortunately.
Yeah, you see here, seeds 113 through 97 unfortunately did not have the magic to make it to the next game. They are going to be eliminated. But if you don't see your name over here and you did participate in a qualifier lobby, congratulations, you've made it to the next round. So let's go ahead and see some of these bottom seeds here.
Yeah, there are a number of commendable scores here, and those that are in the top 96, but unfortunately, with the weightings and the average rank, these players unfortunately did not make it through. But yeah, here we go with our top four, or our bottom four, I guess.
All right, starting off, we've got Argong. Pretty respectable scores in terms of how they had seeded. Got an 85th on LN1. Aside from that, nothing to write home too much about.
Yeah, and at seed 95, we have Hooksai, coming in at an average of 88.82%. These two players are the only two with a B rank average that did qualify.
And finally, getting into the A rank averages, we got Bolivia Craft, one score under that 96 threshold. Other than that, did just fine. Again, a pretty good score compared to the others on LN1.
Yeah, and seed 93, we have Fogershot, the first player with scores all in the top 96. Congratulations, with a 92% average and a 700K average as well.
All right, moving on up here. At number 92, we've got Corey. Corey is in the house, getting an 85th on Hybrid 1 and 81st on LN2. Pretty good.
Yeah, and 91 exploits at an average rank of 88.2, actually tying with seed number 90, but they did have the lower average score, so they were seeded below Diamond there. They had a number of good scores, but they especially shined on the most physical pick, seeding 79th there.
And at number 90, we've got the Diamond with a 93% average throughout, and pretty close scores throughout. Nothing to stand out comparatively to their other qualifier runs. However, we do have a 96th on Hybrid 1, so maybe that's a bit of a weakness.
Yeah, and 89, Tyler's Foot, at an average rank of 85, a bit of a jump there. And moving on.
All right, so at 88, we've got Metzl, 85 rank average, with actually two 85s on their LN2 and Hybrid 2, an 82nd on their Rice 2, and an 83rd on their Rice 1, so pretty well-rounded player all around.
And 87 is Biscuitinho, 1860. Also pretty solid all around, but again with a highest seeding rank on stage 6. Number 86 is Einsel, with a lower accuracy average, but a really strong LN2 for their seeding. And then we have at seed 85, Lala, with a very high average accuracy, 94.79, and a couple scores in the top 80 there.
All right, so moving on ahead to 81 through 84, we've got TB Color coming in at 84th place with a very, very strong 78th on Rice 1 as well as Rice 2. Seems like they are a good Rice player there. 83rd, we're going to see Trooper coming in. Very close scores throughout seed 80 through 84 on every single map. So just a well-rounded player. 82nd, we've got Bao ED. Very low average accuracy. However, that 72nd on LN1 and a 54th on LN2 is very, very good in terms of how they seeded. And finally, at 81st, we have Erasium HD, which is going to be the third Cold Open Cup player that I do recognize, scoring in at a 66 on LN1. So great job there, Erasium.
And moving on to our next four, we have at seed 80, our top 80, Block Chaos, with a highest seed rank at 67th on stage 6, with a 96 actually, which is really good compared to the other players around them. 79 is Mr. Andres with respectable scores all around, but a best Rice 1 at 72. 78th seed is Matthias, and they have, and as well as Mr. Andres, S rank averages above 95%. So we're getting into the some of the more proficient players here, and they had really strong scores in some of the more physical picks, but a 500K on LN2, interestingly. Our seed 77 is Pete 2017, with a couple of those pink scores are top 72s, so good on them. And our next handful of players, go ahead.
Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and see Mid Red with a lot of great scores throughout the first four stages, but I guess when it got a little bit more physical, they couldn't come up clutch. 60th on Rice 1 and a 65th on LN1. Very good scores with that. 75th, we have Me0117. And look at that, our first top 50 score with a 34th on LN1. Seems like a very strong early game LN player. 74th, we have Forever 1227. And they're going to be a bit more well-rounded than the last, with a 61st through 78th, as well as a 58th on Rice 2. So that's going to be the spread of their seedings there. And then we have Epic Man 2 coming in at 73rd. Unfortunately, did quite bad at Rice 1 with a 95th place there under an S rank, but they did get our first top 10 score in our seedings with a 987 on Hybrid 1, so that's very good.
Yeah, that's quite the oddball. And our next handful, our top 72, seed 72nd is a Dragon with a 33rd on Rice 1. Pretty good at ACK there. Seed 71 is BPZYXL with a 97.5 average. That's I think I'm pretty confident that's the best we've seen so far. And some really good scores all around. At seed 70, we have Venom Cypher at exactly average 65th rank and a 96% average. Again, really well-rounded scores. And then seed 69 is One Nutellina One with a nearly 97 average and some really good scores on the long note picks. And moving on here.
Going ahead to seed 68, we've got EG Potato coming in with a almost 97 average on every map. Did pretty bad on the LNs and hybrids, however, they were saved by their seedings with that 26th in Rice 1 and that 43rd on Rice 2. 67th place, we've got Johnny 101. Bit more well-rounded, however, still their best score is going to come from that early game pick with seed 40 on Rice 1 and a 48th on Hybrid 1. 66, we have Echo XF. Very good score with LN1 getting a 48th place. Everything else is going to be in the 50s or 60s range. And finally, we have Sky the Dum Dum coming in at 65th place with a crazy score on LN1. a 980 that is worth as much as 11th seed and also a very respectable 46th place on LN2.
Yeah, we're getting into these consistent 97 averages here. At our 64th seed, we have Kaifi with a 97.38 average and a pretty good score on Rice, too, there, seeding 36th on that. 63rd, we have Zemab with a 908K average. That's the first 900K average we've seen, with honestly pretty well-rounded scores there. At our 62nd seed, we have Kuru with a notable LN1 score there, ranking 24th with a 969, but a bit lower on the Rice 2 side, maybe less of a physical player. Seed 61 is Kokito with another 900K average and nearly a 98 average, actually, but with no real outliers in the scores except for Hybrid 1. And our next four players here.
All right, we've got Wearing Zero at seed 60. Great scores on our Rice 1 and Hybrid 1, 41st and 38th, respectively. Everything else around that 60th range. So I guess when it gets a bit more physical, they fail to meet the bar. And we've got Sussy in seed 59, 35th on LN1, 45th on LN2. So some good scores there, as well as a 43rd on Hybrid 2. Just couldn't really clutch up in the Rice picks with the 70th and 71st there. And then Kuraz in seed 58. Great score by them on LN1. They got a 25th, and everything else seems just fine, except for maybe that Rice 2 did get a 74th. That's a bit low. However, that can be written off. And then seed 57, we have Galactic Calamity. Pretty well-rounded player throughout, got 340ths, and then we have a 53rd on Rice 1, as well as a 71st and a 70th on Ellen. Seems like they're not an Ellen player.
Yeah, and our next four at 56th, we have Oliver Q with seed or rankings in around the 50s and 60s, but a 23rd on Long Note 1. We've seen a handful of outliers on that map already. 55th, we have Taba with really solid scores on Hybrid 2 and Rice 2, but an outlier on Rice 1 at 74th. And at seed 54, we have Mataya, who unsurprisingly does excellently on the Rice stages, especially Rice 1, placing second with a 99.91. Lower on the long notes there, that is to be expected, but well within the qualifying range. Our 53rd seed is Mabel's, with pretty well-rounded scores overall, notably better on the hybrids though. And we are going to break our top 50 here.
Yeah, going ahead with seed 52, we have Mickey GG. Some very good LN scores by them, 36 and 43rd. And then everything else is just about around their placement. 51st, we have Jared Pog. Some interesting scores here. Scored pretty low on what I would consider the less physical picks, however, did great on Hybrid 2 and Rice 2, 41st and 24th, respectively. Seed 50, so finally top 50 here. We got iParacosm, and they have really good LN scores as well. Seed 19 and 20th place there for LN1 and LN2. And then at seed 49, we have Had And with a great score on Rice 1, 23rd place there, and a 37th on Rice 2. And then the LNs just kind of fall a little bit short.
Yeah, and in our top 50 now, we're seeing more and more of these 98% averages. And here we go in our top 48, the upper half. We have Cheese7414 with a really strong average accuracy, 98.46, and just a generally well-rounded player, notably better on LN2, but not by much really. At seed 47, we have Cinematic Gen 634, placing 47th exactly on average rank, with notably good scores on Rice 1 and LN2. LN1 falling behind a little bit at 73rd. Kind of interesting result there. And at 46th, we have Kim Mui with another 98 average, and 24th on Hybrid One, which brought their average up a lot. And our 45th seed is BC1CI9, who had also pretty well-rounded scores, except for on LN1 and LN2. But that 26th on Hybrid 2 really did them some favors.
Going ahead with seed 44, we've got Mitch underscore, who overall did pretty well, very well-rounded scores here, around 30th to 56th throughout all the maps, with the 30th place on Hybrid 2. So good job by them. These accuracies across the board are getting a lot higher. Mitch with a 98.5 average for every map, and at seed 43, we have Mika My Mommy, 26 on LN1, 36 on LN2, and a great score on Hybrid 2 with 20th place. Got a 98.5 for there. On seed 42, we have Insanity 435, and over here they didn't do too well on Rise 2, 71st place, but they made it up with Hybrid 1 getting a 31st place, 28th place on LN2, and a 33rd and 34 on LN1 and Hybrid 2. And finally, at seed 41, we have Hi, my name is Cyril. So we have a 22nd place there with Rice 1. A bit weak in the LNs, however, a 22nd as well on Rice 2. So they are very, very good when it comes to Rice.
And here are our top 40 players. Seed 40 is SenQ, with a number 11 on LN2 and number 18 on Rice 2. Some really high scores there, but surprisingly fell behind on Hybrid 1 with a 76th seed. It is tricky when you only get one run through. At our 39th seed, we have Crazy Pizza Kid with some really well-rounded scores, and then a top 10 on Rice 2. Really good at physicality there. 981K is difficult to beat. At 38, we have Ufixil with a top 10 on Hybrid 1 and Long Note 1. Two really good scores there, and well-rounded everywhere else, I think. And then our 37th seed is YT Albin Zero, with just generally good scores all around, and 980K on Hybrid 1 is especially good.
And finally, breaking into that top 36, we are getting to those players that are very, very, I guess, well-rounded, or probably really good at one skill set, but still can hold their own on another. 36th, we have Mortal Spawn underscore with a 22nd on Hybrid 1, as well as a 31st and 32nd on Hybrid 2 and Rise 2. Good scores by them. Seed 35th, we have Neon Dracon, who got an amazing 13th on Rice 1 and did pretty good on every other map. And then seed 34, we have Cow, that they're gonna get a 18th on Rice 1 as well as 26 on Rice 2. So it seems like they are very good Rice player there, but still has some pretty good scores with a 47th and 44th on the LNs. And finally, we have at seed 33, we have Tevilkin, who got very well-rounded scores throughout, anywhere from 35th through 49th on everything except for Rice 2, where they had a standout performance of seed 23 there for the 960.
Yeah, and we are now breaking into the upper third of players, with our 32 seed being Max Tolini with a 98.66 average, and a 19th place on Hybrid 2 standing out there, and also a solid Long Note 1 score, seeding above their overall at 27th. Our 31st seed is Iron, with a near 99 average. That's really strong, and a good 20th seed on Long Note 1, and just really generally solid scores all around there. At our 30th seed, we have Saita underscore, who managed to get by with their overall solid scores, but their 9th rank on Rice 2 really brought them up with a 983K. That's a really impressive score. And our 29th seed is Sirkamp, with a top 10 on Long Note 2. I think that's the first top 10 we've seen on LN2 there, and some solid scores on Hybrid 1 and Long Note 1 as well.
Going into seed 28, we're going to go ahead and see Charlie 72 with a beautiful 20th place on Hybrid 1, as well as a 13th place on LN1 as well. And not to mention their 20th place on Rice 2. Congrats to them for making it so ahead in terms of seeding. And then we have Snow with our first 99% average, I believe. Coming in with a 15th on LN2 and a 14th on Hybrid 2. Great scores by them. At 26, we have the Legendi was taken. They got a 25th on Rice 1, 25th on LN2, and a 17th on Hybrid 2. And they got really well-rounded scores, so they did get a very good seed because of that. And finally, at seed 25, we have Cub-03 with a top 5 placing on Hybrid 1 with a 990 there, as well as a really good 17th place on LN1 and a 21st place on Hybrid 2.
Yeah, and our 24th seed here is Rezuna, with, I think, earning their seeding through mastery of all skills here. They were really consistent, and a notable 18th seed on Long Note 1. And then our 23rd seed is Beta Carotene, who has a number 8 on Rice 2. That's a really standout score there, and some really solid ones. Such as their Rice 1. And then our 22nd seed is Envy with a 16th on Rice 1 and pretty well-rounded scores everywhere else. And 21st seed is Jaden with a handful of top 20s here, actually. 19th on Hybrid 1, 18th on Long Note 2, and 12th on Hybrid 2. Really solid scores there. And
Yeah, we're
here,
finally in the top 25% of players, so it is getting scary
we're seeing
coming
a lot
in
of
at
99 averages, and we're getting up into the upper 900 Ks. This is where the big guns come out.
pretty much coming in at seed number 20. We're gonna see Raphael PC with a very well-rounded 17th on Rice 1, 16th on Hybrid 1, 19th on LN2, and 18th on Hybrid. 19th on LN2, 18th on Hybrid 2. So, great scores by them. 19th place, we have Mini Egg underscore 23, and they did really well on the LNs, 12th and 7th, respectively. Seed 18 with Babi Blue, who got a 15th on Hybrid 1, as well as LN1, and a 17th on LN2, and even a 21st on Rice 2, which is very good as well. And then in seed 17, we have Darkchaser with a 10th on Rice 1 and a 9th on LN2, as well as an 11th on Rice 2. So crazy scores there by them.
Yeah, and here we go, entering our top 16 players. Coming in at number 16 is Eliminate with our first number 1, a 997 on Rice 1 with a 99.91%. That's just incredible. And fourth seed on Hybrid 2 and Rice 2 as well, showing off his physicality there. But the Long Note 1 and Long Note 2 scores kind of dragged his seeding down a bit. And he is passed by our 15th seed, Axelerix, with more well-rounded scores and a number 3 on Rice 2. So just really good seeding all around. The LN1 did pull him down a bit, but a 15th seed is still really good. And our 14th is AOMDCO, with all their scores being in the top 30, and then 15th, 12th, and 13th on Rice 1, Hybrid 1, and Hybrid 2, respectively. And in our 13th seed is GS Astra, with a handful of really good scores here. 12th on Rice 1, 7th on Hybrid 1, 16th on LN1, and 5th on Hybrid 2. They seem to be a bit of a powerhouse here. And Here we go into our top 12. Take it away, Dinah.
Yeah, top 12 incoming, and at 12th place we have LS Dev. Pulled in their lobby at the last second, but was able to get some crazy, crazy scores in the back half. First on Hybrid 2 and first on Rice 2. I think Rice 2 won out by a country mile, something like to the tune of 2K points is the next best person there. So well played by LS Dev. And then at 11th place, we have Tonals with a 5th place on Rice 1, as well as some pretty rounded scores, 13th through 14th on every other map except for Hybrid 2. 10th place, we have Lot with a 3rd place on LN1 and 6th place on LN2. 6th place on Hybrid 2 as well, so scary LN player there. And then at 9th place, we have our good friend Walmart5193 with some very good scores all around. 4th place on Hybrid 1, 5th place on LN1, and 8th place on LN2.
Yeah, and we enter our top eight. Our eighth seed is Oyama Mahiro with a 6th place on Hybrid 1, a 7th place on LN1, and a top three score on Long Note 2. Really high rankings, as well as a top 10 on Hybrid 2 and number 14 on Rice 2. Some really beautiful scores there. At number 7, we have Tristan Jacob 11. Showing off some of their long note skills, interestingly, with a number 4 on long note 2 and a number 9 on hybrid 2. That's not to say they did not do well on the rice, though, and number 9 on rice 1 and a number 12 on rice 2 is certainly commendable. And at our number 6 seed, we have Netro with a 991 on rice 1 for 8th rank. And a 989 on Long Note 1, getting them second rank there, and then 6th place on Rice 2 as well. They seem to just be a really well-rounded player. Their Hybrid 1 score is a little curious, must have just been a choke in the lobby. After all, it is a do-or-die situation. And our 5th seed is very well-rounded, actually. Good scores from all their stages. It is Bagjetka, with top 10s on Hybrid 1, Long Note 1, Long Note 2, and Hybrid 2, and then 14th and 15th on the rice maps. Really, really solid scores all around, but nothing breaking at 990, and I feel like that's what we're going to be seeing in these top four players. Let's take a look.
Yeah, these top four players are definitely not squidding around. At number 4, we have Captain Savelia, 6th place on Rice 1, 6th place on LN2, 2nd place on, or yeah, 6th place on LN1, 2nd place on LN2. Some crazy scores there, and still very, very competitive with the others on the hybrids. They got 18th and 11th, respectively, as well as a 16th on Rice 2. Number 3, bronze medalist, we have Zubin 4 with very crazy scores all around as well, with a 4th place on Rice 1, 2nd place on Hybrid 1, 8th place on LN1, 12th place on LN2, 3rd place on Hybrid 2, and a top 5 placing on Rice 2. Number 2, we have Konkawe, our silver medalist, got a 3rd place on Rice 1, gold medal on Hybrid 1, 4th on LN1. Their only non-top 5 score here is on LN2 at 21st, and then 2nd place on both Hybrid 2 and Rice 2. And finally, for our top contender in Squid Game, we've got Sudden Death. And they have some crazy scores. First place on both LNs by a large margin, as well as a 3rd place on Hybrid 1. 7th place on each of the rices and an 8th place on Hybrid 2.
And yeah, congratulations to everybody who qualified. Thank you all for playing, those of you who showed up. This sheet will be public soon enough. And great scores, everybody. These were really, really hard maps to try and qualify on, and you only had one run through. It was probably really stressful, but you all put up some amazing scores. And now the only thing left to do is to show you all the second game. Enjoy.
뭐가 이렇게 커? 뭘 시키려고? 야, 뭘 것 같니? 어? 뺑뺑이에서 오래받으게? 정글짐에서 떨어뜨리게? 어?
두 번째 게임을 시작하기 전에 각자 앞에 보이는 네 가지 모양 중
그 어디서 많이 본 거 같은데?
상우야, 어? 어떻게 할까?
글쎄.
지금 즉시 하나를 선택해 이동하시기 바랍니다. 지금 즉시 하나를 선택해 이동하시기 바랍니다.
우리 팀 다 같이 움직일까?
그건 위험할 수도 있어. 아직 뭘 시킬지도 모르는데 다 같이 한 곳으로 갔다가 모두 불리해질지도 몰라.
그런가?
투자에도 그런 말이 있어. 계란을 한 바구니에 담지 마라.
영감님, 얘가 서울대 경영학과 수석 입학. 어릴 때부터 유명한 우리 동네 신동이었어요.
그래? 아이고, 대단한 사람이네.
아, 그럼요. 그럼 상우 말대로 일단 찢어져서 서로 짱을 좀 보자. 응?
내가 삼각형으로 갈게.
그럼 거기는?
나이라.
어?
나이라.
아, 동그라미.
네. 우리 고향 달처럼 생겼어요.
그럼 별이랑 우산이 남는데.
자네부터 골라.
아, 그럴까요? 자, 다들 움직이죠. 무슨 게임인지 알게 되면 그때 다시 모여서 작전 짜고.
Participants must choose one of four shapes: arrow, bar, circle, and diamond. Participants will be able to choose before the map pool showcase next weekend, and anyone who does not choose on time is eliminated. The number of players assigned per shape is capped at 24. Each shape will correspond to a map, along with a target score for each map. Participants must try to get as close to the target score as possible, but must not go over, or their scores will be put to the very bottom. You will only be informed of what the maps and target scores will be after everyone chooses their shape. For this reason, there will be no map pool showcase today.
알라이트. So, that's the name of the game for our second stage of Osumania Squid Game. I hope you guys enjoyed the showcase. Thank you all for showing up. Do you have any last words, Dynascape?
I just hope you guys enjoyed. We did have a lot of fun with the production of this, so it was great to see all the positive reactions for that. So hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll give you the info for what to do for this week, and we'll see you next weekend.
Yeah. Good luck.